Welcome back to Six in the Mix. You know, if you've asked anyone who's been in a loving relationship, they can always pinpoint the day that they met their special someone, right? And knew that person was the one. But what if you're not too sure the one you are with is the one? Here to help you answer that question is America's marriage coach, Dr. Jackie Del Rosario, to share some signs that you are with the right mate. Doctor, welcome. So glad you're here. We have a lot of points to talk about, so let's get right to it.
We do.
What's the first sign to say? Thank you, Mr. Right, Mrs. Right.
Compatibility is everything.
Okay.
So we gotta make sure that the person that we're in love with, we're actually compatible with. That makes a suitable mate. You can fall in love with almost anyone. That doesn't mean that they're gonna be good for you or that it's gonna work well. So compatibility needs to be measured. How like-minded are we?
Okay.
Do we think alike? Do we believe in the same things? Do we value the same things? So your core self needs to be very, very similar.
Let me ask you this though, doctor. What about the yin and the yang, balancing each other out? Because like-minded, I think in my novice mind, you know, values, morals, beliefs, I think are very important.
Absolutely.
You know, depending on the couple. But what about the yin and the yang? You're this way, I'm this way. We kind of balance each other out. What's your opinion on that?
Well, the thing about balancing each other out is temperament. Temperament is different than your core self. That's like that affect. So I might be type A, you might be type B. So we balance each other. I want to go fast, you want to go slow, we balance. But your core issues need to be the same.
Need to be the same. Yes. When you say committed to do the work, what do you mean by that? What type of work we're talking about? Taking out the garbage or
all of the above.
Okay.
Because love is good, but love doesn't make it work. You really need to be committed to doing the work. That other four-letter word, W-O to the R-K.
Okay.
It's not a bad word, it's a good word. And I can't be in a relationship that's gonna go the distance unless you're equally committed as I am equally committed.
And have that conversation, by the way. I mean, you wanna make sure that you are each on the same page about what type of work you're talking about, right?
Right.
I learned that very early on in my marriage.
If
my husband would leave the shoes there, like, I'm not gonna play that game and be like, let me see how long he takes to pick up those shoes. I learned very quickly, if I asked him,
just
he did it.
Just say it.
Just ask nicely and it's gonna happen. What about the idea of being attracted to your partner? I think that's so important. Sometimes we overlook that. Make sure that you like who you're with.
You don't know how many clients I've seen that don't like the person they're with, or they say that there's no chemistry or sexual attraction. That is really basic, you would think, but it doesn't always come to pass. Make sure that you like that person. You like who they are, that there's some chemistry there. It'll keep the passion flaming throughout the years.
I by no means have your expertise, but I like to call it the apple pie theory. If I could be anywhere in the world, like hanging out on the French Riviera with J-Lo, but I'd rather be sitting with you sharing apple pie than you're my man.
That's right. And I think that starts with friendship.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you really like that person, who they are, and you feel comfortable with them, and you're totally authentic with them, and they can be the same with you.
Authenticity. Doctor, thank you so much for your expertise.
We've
got to get you back here. If you want more information from Dr. Jackie, you can just ask. You can visit drjackie.com and also like her on Facebook, follow her on Twitter as well. Doctor, thank you so much for being here.